welcome to the Biddeford Ice Arena. I'm Jay Harper, along with my cameraman tonight, Mark Cantor, bringing you the last regular season contest for Thorne Academy. They come into this matchup against Cheverus with a record of 7-10. Cheverus, on the other hand, 13-3 on the season. A very big matchup. Not so much into the way these teams will finish up for the playoffs, because it looks like both teams will head into postseason play, but a kind of getting to know each other once again. They met the opening game of the season, Cheverus blowing away Thorne Academy 11-3. So a little revenge on the hands of the Trojans. But another factor very key in this one, if Cheverus is to win, more than likely Cheverus will be rated number 3 in postseason, Thorne Academy number 6. That means they would meet this Wednesday night in Portland at the Portland Ice Arena for the first round of the playoffs. If Thorne upsets Cheverus, on the other hand, looking at the heel point standings, I'm figuring out that Cheverus would come in at number 4 and Thorne Academy number 6 still. They wouldn't jump up. Maybe they would jump up to number 5, but there's a good chance they'd meet anyway. So regardless of who wins tonight, these two teams could meet this coming Wednesday for the first round of the playoffs. It's a big game for the Trojans. They just won their last game 9-7 over Kennebunk, but over the last 2 weeks of the season haven't been playing that well hockey. For Cheverus, on the other hand, a marvelous season for Coach Bob Boldick. They come in at 13-3 and been playing outstanding hockey. They're a strong team. They're a quick team, a very physical team, too, and they do a lot of things well. Thorne Academy will have to rely on their big goaltender, Jeff Marston, once again for some great network for the Trojans tonight. On the other hand, the first line of McLeod, Grigsby, and Karen will have to do some offensive work. It should be a great matchup here at the Biddeford Ice Arena. A lot of people on hand. It should be interesting, if anything else, matchup, and then getting to know each other as they head into the first round of the playoffs, because more than likely, these two teams will meet. We're going to come back right after this with the opening face-off and first period action here on CTV 30. We're back right after this. Welcome back to the Biddeford Ice Arena. Jay Harper along with our cameraman tonight, Mark Cantor. Starting lineups being introduced for Cheverus. They will skate this way to start the contest. Peter Malloy on the left wing wearing number 13. On the right wing, Mike Michaud wearing number 18. Centering that line will be Anthony Fasulo wearing number 16. On defense, number 21, Sean Moreau, along with James Hoglund, will wear number 28. In the nets for the Cheverus Stags, number 30, Dan Netto. He's a junior, 5'10", 145-pounder, and he's been outstanding so far for Cheverus this season. Now moving over to the other side for Thorne Academy. Looks like Coach Bob Riley is going with some of his seniors tonight. Kyle Valley, Chris Brewer, and Nicholas Erickson. We're going to pause now for our national anthem here on CTV 30. back out front, shot again, it's loose. McLeod had a chance, couldn't find the handle. Back to the point. Shot in by Hogan. The Trojans, a couple of big opportunities to start this one. Shot back in by John Sherman. Ryan Bell looks to intercept, he does. McLeod with the puck. Now Karen. Troy Karen, shot in, kicked out by Netto. Thorn Academy, controlling action early. Bell keeps it in at the point. McLeod with the puck once again, skating in the middle. Looking for a backhand, drops it back to the point. Hogan in, caught by Netto. Netto holds on for a faceoff to the left. Great action for the Trojans to open up. But a couple of big chances missed. At 13:59 of the first period, we have no score. Cheverus breaking. Pass off. Back to the point now. Set back along the boards. Up front, DeSimone knocks it. And Carey able to clear it. He chases after it. He gets the handle on it. Onside. Got a couple of people on the left. Centering pass. Just misses Grigsby. Grigsby kicks it back in. And Rick Carey gets knocked down. And they're going to let that one go. Amazing. And as we've seen all season, Rick Carey, the brunt of all kinds of action in front of the net. He usually draws the aggressive play from the opponents. Again, he does. It appears no one is going to go out for that. But again, that's something high school hockey shouldn't allow. The referee is allowed to go. It's going to continue. Then you see the cheap foul called. Cheap penalty. Wonder sometimes. Cheverus clears the zone. Skating hard after it. Lisi crosses the red line and icing is called. Back for Bell. Bell sends it in. Netto stops it out front. Trying to clear his Cheverus. Kept back in by Hogan. Tipped out front over the net. Brent Murray. Now E.G. Anderson clears. Seto fighting in front. Shot save Marston out front. A good shot up high. Shot by Murray. Back to the point. Kept in by the Stag. Tipped out front. Marston holds on. Makes a nice save out front. find him, shot in. Cloud knocked down from behind. No call. Puck still loose. Still loose. And the goalie finally gets a hold of it. And all kinds of extra pushing and shoving down in front. Things are ugly early. Thank you. inside the net. It hit inside the post, but it kicked out. No goal. Puck was inside the net for a moment anyway. Hit inside the crossbar, but it kicked it out. If that wasn't a rob, I don't know what is. That's as close as you'll ever come to scoring and not getting it. Great shot by Valley. Hit the right crossbar. Inside the crossbar, actually. Caught enough to kick the puck back out behind Neto. Both teams even now. Neto tripped up. No call. BC poking on Valley. First period. Cheverus Stags lead Thorn Academy 1-0. Rocky High School hockey action on CTV 30. Sear goes after it. Neto can't control it. Chance for Sear. Now Root behind the net. Centering pass out front for Reed. He had him. Reed couldn't collect. Kick back over for DeSimone. Tapped out. Here comes Anderson. Off for Seto. Seto out front. Knocked away nicely by Erickson. Cheverus keeps it in. Trying to clear. Kept in along the boards. Erickson loses his stick out front. Nice play by DeSimone. He skates it out. He's getting hard. Sends it in against Neto. Neto makes a lackluster save. Didn't know where the puck was, but it kicked to the corner. Seto loses it. Throws it to the chance. Root. Now along the boards. Picked up by Hazard. Seto Hazard. Hazard shot. Save Marston. Comes out. Running forward Anderson. Centering pass. Up there. Cheverus tries to keep it in. They can't. Changes up. Simone back. Collects things. Long pass for McLeod. McLeod can't gather. Cleared black out. Sulo fighting along with Malloy. Shot in. Kicked out by Marston. Can't believe that shot by Kyle Valley didn't score. Inside the post and somehow kicked back out. Centering pass for Fasulo. Blocked nicely by Karen. Sherman trying to break. Can't. Dump back in the Trojan zone. Right out front. Great save. Marston kicks it away. A perfect opportunity for Peter Malloy, but he couldn't find the handle. Great save, Marston. We're still at 1-0. Pass clears the zone and Cheverus back to collect. Going changing up again. Nobody back now for the Trojans. Offside is Eric Broadus. And a faceoff will be outside for Academy Zone. 6:01 left, first period. Cheverus Stags hold the 1-0. shot just wide of the net. Grigsby can't clear. Kept in by Murray. Now Hogan. Cheverus changes lines. Hogan now just ices the puck. And with 4:35 left in the first period, it'll be a face-off. Left, Jeff Marston. Last regular season contest. Northrop Academy and Cheverus. Cheverus coming in with a 13-3 mark. 7-10. This could well be the prelim of what's to happen Wednesday night in the first round of the tournament. Good chance these two teams will meet each other. McLeod with a chance. Defense falls down. McLeod comes in. Shot, score! Underneath Neto. McLeod keeps it on the ice. The Cheverus defenseman fell down as McLeod came clear. And we're tied at one. Shot by Jim McLeod. We're tied at one. This has to be a vast improvement for Coach Riley and the Trojans compared to their 11-3 shellacking by the Stags opening up this season. Troy Karen skating out now. It's Sherman on the left. We got a whistle. Penalty way behind the play. Looks like Erickson, the break's gonna draw it. Got a break from the Trojans. They were breaking. Erickson picks it up. So Trojans try to kill this penalty. Riley sends out Grigsby, Bentley, Ryan Bell. Alley, nice job clearing it. Goes back in. Drapo now, number 24, down the left side. Shot in on Marston, save. Shot in again, save. Marston holds on. Good job, Jeff Marston. Two nice saves. And Malloy had a shot from the right side. And the rebound came out. Any wood on it. Number 18, Mike Michaud. Face off to the left of Marston. Trojans a man short. Face off right out front. Puck still loose. Look behind the net. Sumo and Hogan doing battle up front. Hogan collects and clears the zone. Down to a minute. 15 in the power play. 50 left. In the period, Valley almost a chance to steal there. Here comes Malloy skating hard, number 13. Going around Chabot, centering pass out front. Collected though by Grigsby, and he clears it out. Academy's a good penalty killing early. Down under a minute now. In the power play for Cheverus. Stolen away by Grigsby, but Valley inside the zone for the offside and a faceoff. Just outside Cheverus's blue line. 2:33 left, first period, we're tied at one. Watching high school hockey action on CTV 30. Jay Harper along with cameraman Mark Cantor bringing you the last contest in the regular season for the Trojans. Sherman. He can't find it, but they're onside. McLeod back up. Sherman behind the net. Can't get the centered pass. Still with it, though. Looks out front. And it's picked up by Cheverus. Reese kicks it over for number 15, Mark Karen. Karen stops and sends it in the Thornton zone. Larson kicks it back now for Hogan. Hogan skating it out. Long pass broken up by Aceto. Hogan gets it back, though. Here he comes. Over the line. Slap shot long. McLeod goes for the loose puck. Gets it on the right board. Trying to stick work in. Knocked away. Cheverus comes skating out hard. E.J. Anderson. Centering pass. Misses everybody. Hogan collects. Being forechecked back there. Toughly by Cheverus. Aceto with a shot. Hits off Bell. We're down to 40 seconds in the period. Cheverus keeping the pressure on. They come out with a puck. Shot in on Marston. Makes the save. Puck loose. Marston just able to get the handle on it before Aceto comes in with another chance. Thornton Academy avoids disaster right before the end of the third period. First period, 34 seconds left. We're tied at one. Faceoff will be to the left of Marston. Mike Roop out there centering against number 19, E.J. Anderson. Anderson wins the faceoff, but it's stolen away by Sear. Sear coming down the right side, trying to clear it in. He gets checked hard over there by Sean Moreau. Moreau kicks it back out. Trojans out to center ice. We're down to 20 seconds, but here comes Aceto. Aceto shot in. Nice save. Puck loose again. Anderson with a chance. Anderson looking out front. Again, Marston quick with the stick. Knocks it away. Goes behind the net. Reed looking for the puck. Aceto sends it back to the point. Kick back in along the boards. We're down to 2-1, and that's going to do it. Thornton Academy avoids disaster. Cheverus all the pressure on that last minute. But Thornton Academy skating hard, and they skate to a 1-1 tie at the end of the first 15. You're watching high school hockey on CTV 30. We're going to take a quick pause and come back with first and second period intermission, and then the second period here. Back right after this. Welcome back to the Biddeford Ice Arena. I'm Jay Harper along with you on CTV 30. Tonight, Thornton Academy and Cheverus doing battle. And at the end of the first period, we're tied at one. A very exciting, hard-fought first period. Thornton Academy dominating early but unable to score. Cheverus answered at 2:27 of the first. James Hazard from E.J. Anderson beating Jeff Marston in a 1-0 lead for Cheverus. And then it was pretty even up and down. Both teams getting a lot of chances but no scoring. And then late in the first period at 10:36, Jim McLeod from Troy Karen and John Sherman even things up at one when he came in alone against Dan Netto for Cheverus, making things tied at 1-1. After that, the last minutes of pressure were all Cheverus. Marston able to hold them off. And at the end of one, we're tied at one. Considering the opening game of the season against Cheverus, which Thornton Academy lost 11-3, a much better game. Thornton Academy has to feel better about themselves and a lot of confidence, and maybe a chance for a big upset going into the playoffs, because as I have said, these two teams very likely will meet in the first round no matter what happens tonight. It could be a twist of things, of course. When you're dealing with heel points, you never really know for sure, but very well, these two teams could meet Wednesday night at the Portland Ice Arena. Last regular season contest here on CTV 30. So far, Thornton Academy 7-10 on the year. They've beaten Kennebunk twice, Scarborough twice, they've beaten Cape Elizabeth, and also South Portland for their victories on the year. Cheverus, on the other hand, has dominated pretty much everybody, and they're 13-3, and a great season for Coach Bob Bolding and his team. But in the first period, Trojans fighting even, doing a good job. They're tied at one. We're very excited to bring you this last contest here on CTV 30. A reminder, once again, will be Tuesday night at Thornton Academy, where the Thornton Academy basketball team will do battle with Bonnie Ego. They lost last night to South Portland. Very hard-fought loss for them, losing by 7 to the Red Riots. So things could be tough going into Bonnie Eagle and Biddeford the last two games of the year, but still a chance to make the playoffs for the Trojan boys basketball team. And we'll be there Tuesday night, so make sure you tune in after that, because, of course, this game will be brought back to you. You should be able to view this game here Wednesday and Thursday night on CTV 30. I'm Jay Harper along with my cameraman, Mark Cantor. We're going to take a pause and be right back with second period action on CTV 30. shots in that first period. Cheverus 16, Thorn Academy 15. As even as the score was, we're still tied at 1. We see against Grigsby. Fuck loose. Valley comes up with it. Kept in on the boards by Cheverus. Josh DeSimone now fighting back there with Mark Carron. Grigsby now skating out. Long pass across ice for Rick Carey. On sides. Skating in. It's checked. But the Cheverus player goes down and Carey back in for checking. Picked up by Drapo. Kept in. Puck still on the ice. Stags have a jam up. Got a hand pass, I believe. First game tonight at the Biddeford Ice Arena. Biddeford against St. Dom's. Number 2, St. Dom's, and number 3, Biddeford. Skating to a 1-1 tie. After playing 8 minutes overtime, no one could score. Ended up tied at 1. So those 2 and 3 teams pretty even as well. That's our score here. 1-1, second period action. Cheverus keeping it in. Kicked in behind the net. BC goes after it. Up front is Broadus. Carron now fighting behind the net. Rick Carey tries to clear up. Mark Carron comes up with it. He's got Broadus out front. And he takes a hit at Erickson. He levels him. I don't know what to say about that hit. A couple of hands awful high in the face, but he's a one-man wrecking machine now. Mark Carron, number 15, and he's going to go off this time for the high elbow to the face. Could have got it last time. He gets it this time. He went up high both times with the hands, and this time he draws the 2-minute penalty. Shot out front, puck loose, shot, score! Rick Carey, number 9, the freshman! Got the rebound on the Grigsby shot and kicked it back in high into the net, beating Netto in the Trojans' lead 2-1 with 10:37 left in the second period. big goal for the Trojans. And there was 13 seconds left in the power play, so that is a power play goal for Thornton Academy. They now lead 2-1. Shot in. Oh, tipped away. And just goes wide of the net. Loy over there with a hard hit along the boards. Trojans keep it in, though. Centering pass again. Back for the point. Sear now collects the loose puck along the board. Sends it along. Down deep. Roop going in for a check-in once again. Roop doing a great job in there. Little number four, Mike Roop. Behind the net. Centered out. Back to the point for Erickson. Winds up. Slap shot. Netto. Flying out of the net and makes a save in the air about 14 feet in front of his crease. Great save by the junior, Dan Netto. Cheverus now verbally attacking one another and the officials on the bench. Coach Bob Bulbeck trying to tell the team, enough comments, let's play hockey. They trail 2-1. Trojans, cloud centering this line. Karen with a loose puck. Sends it in. Netto kicks it away. Thornton Academy showing what they got so far in this one. Lead around by Netto. Looking for the loose puck with McLeod. Couldn't find it. Bell did a good job taking out the body of Reese, number 9. It's along the dasher. McLeod clears it out. Cheverus back with it. And kick back out. And number 14 for the Stags. Broadus looking for Reese. Bell clears it out. Kept in by Drapo. And now here comes Hogan down the left side. He's got Sherman. Centers for Sherman. McLeod will go in forechecking. Trying to get to it first. Drapo back there with him. McLeod collects. Clears it around. Karen and McLeod both in there. Buck along the boards in the corner. McLeod kicks it out front. Jeff is coming in. Hulk out there. Centering pass and no one at the point for Thornton Academy. Losing his stick. Number 15 for the Trojans. And now Reese causing trouble. Shabbat back there. Backhander in. Nice save by Marston. Used the pad hand. Made the big save. L'Esperance, number 15 for Thornton Academy, still out there. Now stolen away by the Stags. Trojans in trouble. The Trojans gonna clear it out. Marston dumps for Shabbat. Keeping in. Now goes on the point for Hazard. Hazard centering pass. BC collects, puts it down. Trojans come back in. And now here comes Sherman being ridden from behind. Stick handling in. Could have called the offsides. They don't. And the Stags clear it back in. Shabbat goes after it. They wave off the icing. Great action here in the second period. Trojans leading 2-1. Hazard dumps it in. Erickson gets it, clears the zone. Back there, Murray. Cross for Doherty. Grigsby gets it in the middle, though. Here comes Grigsby. Room up the middle. Breaks out to the left side. Centering pass. Knocked down from behind. No call. Center for Valley. Valley can't get it. Erickson trying to keep it in. Now Josh DeSimone chasing. There's it back. Nice job, and it goes into Cheverus' zone. 7:20 left. Second period. Offside, they wave it. Erickson sends it out along the dasher. Tipped out by Carey. Nice job. He has Thornton Academy's second goal. Carey knocks down along that board. Number 18, which is Mike Michaud. Now the clear. Marston comes way out of the net. Clears it out up into the stands. Well, actually off the net. It'll be a face-off. Call. It appears they call it delay a game on Marston. effort. Chance to break out. Can't do it. Out again, though. Now he clears the zone. Stags send it back in against Marston. Marston now dumps it back behind for Bell. Bell around the board, looking for McLeod. Stags keeping it behind the net. Boy out front, a shot just wide of the net. Behind there, shot again. Again! Four shots for the Stags. Three on net, one just wide. And they apply a lot of pressure, but Marston equal to the task. Here they come once again. Centering pass, all alone. Shot wide of the net. Mike Micho, along with Fasulo and Malloy, causing all kinds of problems, but they can't come up with a goal right now. They trail 2-1. Behind the net again. Malloy now. Looking out front. Shot off the post! Trying to keep it in is Hoglund. Hoglund does. Behind the net. Bell sending it out for McLeod. McLeod now ices it, gets it out. We're down to 50 seconds left in the penalty. Micho, Fasulo, and Malloy. All kinds of pressure, but couldn't come up. Missed numerous opportunities. Micho had the best. Number 18 had a couple of great chances. Centering pass for Fasulo. Broken up there. Now Sherman with it. Sherman will clear it back. 25 seconds now remaining in the penalty to Marston. In serve by Sear. Back come the Stags. They wind up. That's clearly offsides. Play offsides. Home Academy clears, so no call. Back once again. Moro chasing it. Looking for a pass. Broken up by Grigsby. Grigsby forechecking. Great job here. Still fighting. Put the puck down. Trying to knock it in. Sherman goes in now. Good job by the Trojans. Erickson back there. Carey now puts it back in. And there'll be a face-off. Penalty is up. 4:35 left. Second period. Trojans kill the penalty. Great job out there by Jeff Marston. Along with the latecomers. Carey, Erickson, Grigsby, and Sherman. Coach Rally sends out Mike Root now, Mark Reed, and Tat Sear. Back on defense. Lesperance and BG Shabbat. Back trying to break out Lesperance. Luckily clears it away. Group going now deep. Now Lesperance picks it up. Stick work. Gets it along the board. Sia trying to get it out now. Kept in. Shot in. On Marston. Reed clears it. All icing. Four on four left, second period, face off to the left of Marston. Group still out there with Reed. Shabbat on defense. There's along the board for Reed. And Reed breaks out one. He's got Root. Along with Sear. Blasted from the left point. Nice save by Neto. That could have caught in the left corner. But here comes the Stags breaking out on 3-on-2. Pass in. Back is Lesperance and Shabbat. Shot save Marston. Marston goes for it, collects. And he gets the faceoff to the right. 3:39. Class B high school action right now. The standings, really number one, York number two. Dartmouth and Cheverus kind of a tie depending on tonight's outcome. They're 3-4. Cape Elizabeth number five and York Academy number six. Getting along that left side now. 27, Murray. Back to the point for Broadus. Broadus shoots in wide of Marston. Cloud goes over there, Reese. Fights, checked by Bell. McLeod gathers behind the net. Chased by Broadus. Here comes McLeod, picking up speed. Cuts in, cuts back. Checked off the puck. And now gathering it in is Mark Caron, number 15 for Cheverus. McLeod steals, though. Shot in, just kicked out by Neto. Now Caron goes back to the point for Hogan. Hogan. And Sherman now sends it out to center ice. Carey with a chance for the steal. Troy Karen picks it up. Shot in, blocked. Troy Carey had a nice chance. Knocks down another player, still with a puck. And poked away by the Stags, and they break out. 3-on-2, 3-on-1, and a nice reach poke by Brian Bell. Stick check. No penalty there as Carey took down another man. They're after him, and he's fighting back with some great checks on his own. Puck comes in against Marston. Marston dumps it back to Erickson. Erickson along the board, kept in by the Stags. Hazard. Back there with PJ Anderson. Anderson now trying to get it. He's got a set up front. Kept in on the point. Puck still in. Now Valley breaks out. Carey trying to come in with him. Valley goes to the corner. Referee falls down. Valley goes down. Rigsby for checking. Puck still in the corner. Stags trying to clear it. DeSimone there to gather it in. Sends it back in. Rigsby ridden to the boards. Again, that move that hangs out here gives us a lot of problems in that corner to see the action. A lot of things going on down there. Now Aceto comes out with it. Pass out. Stags try to break. On sides. E.J. Anderson pack over for Aceto. Aceto! No! Hit the post! And payback time! Payback time! The same shot Kyle Valley had, hit the same post and kicked out inside the net and kicked it away. No goal waved off as it was knocked back in by the Stags. But the whistle had blown, and that puck was whistled by Aceto for that same exact goal post, left post, and it kicked out. 1:02 left, second period. Trojans still on top, 2-1. Stags keep it in, good hard pressure. Shot from the point, goes in on Marston. He'll hold on for another faceoff. Great action here in the second period. Jeff Marston again. His normal self in the net. Most amazing. Faceoff won by the Stags, poked away though by the Trojans. Out they come, nice pass off for Roop. Roop loses control, looking back. Big hit over there on Mark Reed. He goes down. He's shaken up. Lesperance now clears it back in. And they'll call the icing. Trojan player down. And they call the icing with 38 seconds left, second period. You're watching high school action on CTV 30. Saturday night at the Biddeford Ice Arena. And the last regular season contest for both these teams, and it's been a beauty so far. Jay Harper along with my cameraman, Mark Cantra. The Trojans doing battle with the Stags. Face off, Fasulo gets it, score! Fasulo won the face off. I don't know if he'll get credit with a goal. I think he might. Also in there, number 13, Malloy. Tough break with only 30 seconds left in the period. Actually 35. So at 14:25, the Stags even it up. Micho gets it, number 18. Chulo. So Fasulo gets the assist on the faceoff. It was Micho who knocked it in. Trojans and the Stags are now tied at 2. Karen centers out front. Neto with a nice save. And again, that's a penalty right there. And they get the call. Cheverus, every time a Trojan player near the net, I know you got to keep them out of there, but overly aggressive. And then when it's on the other end of the ice, they hang all over Marston. And a cheap shot. We'll have a penalty on that one. 14 seconds left in the period. Face off one. Karen sends it in. minutes in that second period, both teams having 12, and both getting one pass. They're goaltenders. Marston, 11 saves. Neto, 11 saves. A great second period. The Trojans, though, have to be a little bit stung allowing that goal with only 35 seconds left in the second period. Pasulo won the faceoff, knocked it over to the right, and that enabled Micho to get the puck and just kind of slap it along the ice very slowly past Jeff Marston, who was out of the action, kind of out of play there and out of position. And a great shot for the Stags, a good faceoff by Pasulo. A great second period, a lot of action up and down. The Trojans kept the pressure on the Stags, and as we ended the first 15 minutes after 30, we're tied once again. Right now, it's 2-2. This, of course, the last game of the season for both these teams, and more than likely, as I said before, they will meet in the playoffs. If the Stags win, Coach Bob Bolden for Cheverus figures he'll move up to number 3. That'll keep the Trojans at number 6 where they are right now. So that would mean 3 and 6 playing each other at the Portland Ice Arena Wednesday night. But if the Trojans should upset Cheverus, I think that will catapult Thorn Academy over Cape, moving into number 5. Cheverus will stay at number 4. Yarmouth will go to number 3, and 5 and 4 will play. I don't know if that'll be the same Wednesday night at Portland or not. I don't know the situation, but more than likely these two teams will play again. First time these two teams met, Trojans losing badly 11-3. Tonight, a much better contest, a better game. Thorn Academy has to feel very good. Regardless, if they face this team again, they now know they can play with them. Of course, home ice might have something to do with it, but Cheverus has played here a number of times during the season as well, as they play York, Kennebunk, and other teams right here at the Biddeford Ice Arena. So not that much of a factor. Good crowd on hand. A great night for hockey. Saturday night hockey on CTV 30. We're going to take a break and come back with the final 15. We're tied at 2, and we're back right after this. Welcome back to the Biddeford Ice Arena. I'm Jay Harper bringing you tonight's action between 7-10 Thorn Academy and 13-3 Cheverus. After two periods, we're tied at 2. It's been a great contest. Both goaltenders, juniors, both outstanding in the nets for their teams. Jeff Marston so far 26 saves. Neto for Cheverus 25. At 2:27 of the first period, James Hazard got Cheverus on the board. Assist going to E.J. Anderson. It was 1-0 Cheverus at 10:36. Jim McLeod answered back from Troy Karen and John Sherman. And we were tied at 1 after one period. In the second, Rick Carey put Thorn Academy on top 2-1. Assist going to Valley and Grigsby. And then at 14:25, only 35 seconds left in the second, Micho from Pasulo. Pasulo won the faceoff, and Micho put it past Marston. And we're tied at 2, and that's where we stand entering the final 15 minutes. Great hockey game so far. We're enjoying ourselves here. High school students, once again, want to remind you, this coming Saturday night down at the Brunswick and Old Orchard Beach, it'll be Chem-Free Saturday with Laser Karaoke, which is the sing-along system, the videos, and we'll have some contests and prizes, and we've invited the students from Thorn Academy, Biddeford, and Old Orchard. The cover is just $350, and hopefully all come down and have a good time. We'll be there for that one. Loud with the puck. Sends it back to the point. Shabbat. Trying to send it. Stolen away, though. Here comes Pasulo. Breaking in on Marston. 1-on-1. Shot saved, Marston. It's loose on the ice. Picked up by the Stags. Pasulo got it. He missed a golden opportunity for the Stags. Checked hard against the boards. Hogan. Hand pass by Hogan. There'll be a face-off to the left of Marston. Marston has been brilliant. There again, showing his talents, and he makes save against Pasulo, barreling in all alone. Penalty shot style opportunity for the Stags. Face off now to the left. Sherman going against Pasulo. Pasulo trying to win it, walk it again as he did on the last time. But the Stags even things up in 2. Puck knocked around behind the net. Shabbat with it. On him and skate it out. Looks for the pass now. And broken up by the Stag. Karen will forecheck though. Going against Hoglund. Knocks Hoglund against the board. Sherman with it. Sherman loses it. Ice still a little wet. Here comes the Stags. 3-on-2. Pass across. Pasulo on sides. Poked down from behind. They're going to let that one ride. That could have been a tripping call. They got away with that one. Wave off the icing. Karen behind there. Puck's behind him. Trying to get it to Sherman. Sherman comes in. another chance. Back is Shabbat. Sulo, nice shot along the ice. Great save again, Marston. Karen now with a chance. He falls down. Forechecking McLeod makes the steal, but he can't come in. On Neto, back to the point, kept in by the Trojans. Along the ice, sent over for McLeod. McLeod looking out front. He's got Sherman going back. Now Karen. Karen and McLeod trying to forecheck. Out comes Murray. Broken up by the Trojans. Aceto trying to break in. Sherman now for Karen. Karen, shot! Oh! Almost by Neto. Got the glove on it, but couldn't hold on. McLeod trying to forecheck now. Great action. Opening moments. Third period. We're tied at two. Stolen away by Karen. Karen sending it back in. We're going up and down the ice. Here comes Aceto. He clears it in the Thornton zone. Goes in on Marston. Marston holds on. It'll be a face-off to the right of Jeff Marston. Great action. Opening 2.5 moments. Both goaltenders outstanding. Academy changes up, as does Cheverus. Puck kept in by the Stags. As they're trying to keep it in, he has Cheverus' first goal. Kept in and now cleared out. Aceto dumps it in the zone, chasing in there for the puck is E.J. Anderson. Anderson, number 19, but Hazard out front, 23. Center pass, score! Hazard from Anderson. Great pass. Hazard perched to the left of Marston. Nothing Jeff Marston could do about that one. And the Stags take the lead, 3-2. 3 minutes, 50 seconds of the third. Cheverus goes back on top. I thought it was number 23. They're saying it's 28. We'll have to check that. Hoglund is number 28, no question. And Hazard is 23. 23 is on the ice now. I didn't see Hoglund in there. Regardless, Cheverus on top. 3-2 now. It's a pass for Sear. He's checked off the puck. Leveled in the corner. Freshman gets up with knees. That should draw a penalty. Cheverus played against York here. Saw a lot of that game. Great goal. Thank you. Didn't think I was losing my mind. It was Hazard, his second goal of the night. Ninety percent of the time, we're better than the officials. Karen gets the penalty for Cheverus. Jojo's trying to skate out. Cloud, stick work. Coming onside, drop back pass to Sherman. Sherman dumps it in. Karen goes in. Kept in along the board. Hogan dumps it back in. Karen and McLeod going for it. Karen tips it to McLeod. McLeod coming on. Left point. Out front. Backhand shot. Troy Karen shot in. He had an unbelievably golden opportunity. Couldn't connect. Great save, Anderson. I mean, Neto, excuse me. Things were in slow motion there. It looked like Troy Karen had all day long to put that one past Dan Neto, but couldn't do it. Neto comes up big, and we're still at 3-2. That was a great chance. back from McLeod. Uh-oh, 2-on-1 breakout. Masulo and Nisho. Shot Masulo, shot save Marston. The kid is unbelievable. Can't say it enough. Dan Nettle, though, has been equal in the other side of the net for the Cheverus Stags. We've had a great contest. 9:59 left, 45 seconds left in the penalty to Cheverus. Thorn Academy on the power play. They've had a couple of great chances, but Neto has kept them out. We're still at 3-2. Cheverus opened up on top. Thorn tied. Thorn went ahead. Cheverus tied, and now Cheverus on top. Back and forth. Great game tonight. Brings me now. Looking for carry. Knocked back in by Cheverus. Shabbat now. The Trojans looking to pass it out. Comes out free. Kyle Valley in the middle. Looking across for Carey. Carey comes in. Poked out. Erickson trying to keep it in. He does along the boards. Carey now has it. Skating out front. Stops. Positions himself. Gets shot in, but it hit off the pad of Hazard. Cheverus, great job over there along the board. By Bisha, number 18. Alley breaking out. We're even now. Shot, score! Trojans get the goal! Neto went up with a glove, the kind of shot that floated, and it was on its way down. Neto missed it, and it went high into the left side of the net. And the Trojans draw even at 3-3. 9:04 left. Kyle Valley. A fluke sort of goal, but a nice wrist shot, and it was up in the air, and it was fluttering. Neto flashed out, couldn't make the save. And with 9 minutes to go, we're tied at 3. Here come the Stags, barreling in on Marston. Broken up by Bell. Puck loose, picked up by the Stags. Shot, score! No, it's being disallowed! The officials are waving it off! We don't know why, but it's being waved off. All the kicking. Got the assist on the Valley goal. And that goal disallowed because Cheverus player kicked it in. Kept in at the point. Nice move by the Stags. Puck still loose. Still got it. Shot in on Marston. Down, making the save. Too much pressure on Marston. The kid is being asked to do too much. Thorn Academy has to tighten up on the D. They draw even, and then all the pressure comes back against them. A good check out there. Karen getting knocked over. Marston. Marston throws the puck at him. Mark Karen, a 5'6" sophomore. Tough, aggressive player. Face-off controlled by Thorn Academy. Out comes McLeod. Break it back. Defenseman falls down. Here he comes again. Shot coming in, flying in. The net's dislodged. And the face-off will be to the left. A great play by Hoglund, diving in. As number 21 fell down when McLeod made his move, Sean Moreau. As McLeod scored his first goal, he had another great opportunity. Defenseman fell down, but Hoglund, number 28, came diving in to knock away McLeod's wrist shot at the last second. 8:14 left. Third period, we're tied at 3. You're watching Thorn Academy High School Hockey on CTV 30. official that called that. I believe he called the tripping against McLeod. Coach Bob Riley trying to get an explanation on that. He said the outside official over on the board called the penalty. Then they waved it off. Face off McLeod. Karen on there. Karen gets it. Trying to go deep. Knocks it in. Sherman forechecking. Over there with Hogman. Falling down, both of them. They go down. Sherman getting back up. Boy now sends it back behind the board. McLeod going after it. He gets the puck. Skating around. Pressure on him. Skates out front. Puts it through another player's legs. Jim McLeod show around the net. Back for Karen. Karen gets it. Dumps it back for McLeod. McLeod not there. Puck still loose. Behind the net. Hoglin pressured by Karen. Puck off. Kept in at the point. Throwing Karen back there. Fighting with Moreau. Centering pass out front, and Fasulo picks it up. Here he comes. Picking up. Fasulo has it. Shot from the point. Save. Marston. And he holds on. Another nice save. Fasulo with a nice shot. Show was there with him, and Malloy came in late. 7:25 left in the third period. Couldn't ask for a better finale here on CTV 30. Gordon Academy lost their first time around to Cheverus 11-3 tonight. It's been a great contest. You couldn't ask for a more even hockey game. Shots are almost even, and the score is even. We're in the third and final period. Grigsby out centering against Fasulo. Kyle Valley now comes out for Thorne Academy. Boy, position right behind Fasulo. First for a backdrop. Wave out Fasulo. Malloy comes in now. Face off one by Malloy. Rick Carey gets in there to knock it out. Clears the zone. Peter Malloy winding up now. Dumps it inside the zone. Lesperance can't clear it. Kept in by Cheverus. Now goes out to Valley. Malloy there to knock it out. Knocked back out by the Trojans. Trying to be put back in by Cheverus. And it's cleared away by Thorne Academy. They're going to call the icing. Great action here at the Biddeford Ice Arena. Still no word tonight. Thorne Academy made out in track action. State meet up at both boys and girls in action. Academy trying to pull off the state title. Though we got ourselves a hockey game tied at 3. 6:50 left. Lesperance back there for the Trojans. Centering pass comes out back to the point for Cheverus. Shot back in. Lesperance picks it up for Thorne Academy. Clears along the board, but it's kept in by the Stags. Doherty sends it back in. In come the Stags. Centering pass just tipped out and it's cleared out nicely. Just far enough so it won't be icing. And Grigsby coming back forechecking against Murray. Murray along the boards, looking for Doherty. Hazard now takes a hit from Carey. Out comes Anderson. Seto sends it in. Marston kicks it out. Anderson with the puck. Stops, cuts. Looking to center it. Knocked down by Brian Bell. It's out front. Save. Marston and a little melee out front. Valley Carey all in there against number 27, Andrew Murray. Face-off will be to the left of Marston. 6:11 left. First game tonight between Biddeford and St. Dom's in Class A action. They went to a 1-1 tie in overtime. Maybe headed for overtime here. Academy 7-10 on the year. Cheverus 13-3. Face-off loose. Picked up now by Hogan. Hogan goes behind the net. Being checked there by the Stags and stolen away by Karen. Again, deep in that corner, it seems where a lot of the action has been in the third period. Tough for our cameras to find it over there because of that thing that sticks out, which is a radio booth. I wish the Biddeford Ice Arena would get rid of that. Breakaway chance for Brewer. Chris Brewer coming down the left side. Shot just across and just wide. He did the right thing, laid it softly for that corner. Bell keeps it in. Neto makes the save, tries to sweep it around. Back there, Brewer And Sear forechecking. Now Root comes in. Knocked down. And the Stags will break it back out. Centering pass, though. Picked up. And now kept in by Mark Charon. Number 15. Stock pulls up looking for the slap shot. In on Marston. Glove save. Jeff Marston. Mark Charon, great shot. Marston just keeps adding to his save total. He's going to be up around the 35 mark by now. 5:20 left, third period. You're watching Thorne Academy High School Hockey on CTV 30. This is the type of night you wish you had a partner to share some of the verbal talk with here. Have my hands full with a great game. Very exciting hockey. Hope that the voice stays in. The pass along over for Charon. Troy Charon on sides, they say. McLeod kicks it in, still with it. Now Troy Charon fighting for it. Back to the point, kept in by the Trojans. Troy Charon will go back for it. McLeod looking for a soft spot in the zone. Tipped out for him. Along the boards. He's checked over there. Cheverus tries to clear it. Kept in by Erickson. Sent in. Goes behind the net. Sherman with it. Centering pass. Tries. Charon. It's still loose back there. The goalie can't get at it. Sherman now sends it around. McLeod will be able to get it in the corner. Jim McLeod looking for someone. Cuts out front. He's got a chance for himself. Poked away at the last minute by the Stags. We're down to 4:30 in the third period. McLeod again forechecking. Kept in by Erickson once again. In for Troy Charon. Backhander in for Neto. Makes the save. And the rebound came out dangerously. Long pass for Fasulo. Marston will hang on as Fasulo came barreling in on him. Great action in front of Dan Neto, the junior goaltender for Cheverus. But Thorne Academy couldn't come up with a big shot. Face-off will be to the right of Jeff Marston. Fasulo, Malloy, and Micho out for Cheverus. Grigsby, Valley, and Carey. Shot. Point-blank range. A slap shot by the captain of the Stags, Peter Malloy. But Jeff Marston right there. If there's ever a goaltender in the state of Maine playing high school hockey that could move on and play hockey at another level, whether it be college or professional ranks in Canada or something else, Jeff Marston is certainly labeled for it. All kinds of raw talent. Shabbat steals the pass, sends it in. Neto stops it behind the net. Carey forechecking. Has a chance for it along the boards. Lesperance dangerously going in there for it. Knocks it out front. Valley with it. Shot. Neto save. It's loose. Neto making the saves, but he's being very careless. Not able to hold on, and rebounds are coming out. Centering pass. Beautiful one from Carey to Valley, and Valley tried to hit it on the move, and he couldn't. Cheverus with a breakaway now. Fasulo, the pass in for him. Comes barreling in, but he can't get it. And he pushes Marston in the head out front, and he's still punched there. Now he goes in and nails Valley. Vicious play by Cheverus as they heat things up. But here comes Grigsby. Grigsby coming in. He's tripped. That could be a penalty shot. We'll see what the call is. He was coming in alone. 3:03 left. A vagrant tripping call. We'll see if we'll get a penalty shot on that. We just might. Everyone clear it out. Yes, we have a penalty shot. 3:03 left. Third period. We're tied at 3. Grigsby going against Neto. This is what high school hockey is all about. Love to see that penalty shot. Tripping and the penalty shot. Grigsby was barreling on Neto. Here we go. And the crowd has drawn silence on the other side, anticipating Chris Grigsby. No amateur when it comes to shooting on net. Neto has been brilliant in the nets. We'll see if he can answer. Here we go. What a ball game. Harper along with cameraman Mark Cantor, our first ever to witness that penalty shot. Grigsby picks it up. Here he comes. Neto out of the net. Fake shot. Save! Dan Neto kicked it out with a skate. A great save. Grigsby had him down but couldn't lift the puck. Neto got the skate on it. And we're still tied at 3. They still have the penalty up there, so I believe they get the penalty shot and the penalty, which is rare or not done in professional hockey, I do not believe. And again, we're not real accustomed to seeing the penalty shot. There they go, they have to pull the skater off. So yes, they'll have only 4. Cloud, Karen, Sherman, Bell, and Hogan on defense. Face off 1, but picked up by Karen. Troy Karen going behind the net, looking out front, controlling. Back to the point for Hogan. Hogan sends it in, tipped out front. Karen with a hit, just goes wide. McLeod leveled out front, and Cheverus is going to get another penalty. So it'll be 5-on-3 for a minute 46. Troy Karen has had 2 or 3 just unbelievably close opportunities where he just has the time but can't quite get the handle on it and get it by Neto. Neto has been brilliant, as has Jeff Marston. I'm losing my voice, losing my mind. This is unbelievable. The Ford Academy crowd up above cheers on the Trojans. So it'll be 5-on-3 for a whole minute 46. The first penalty had only expired 14 seconds, so a 2 minute and a minute 46. Trojans will have the power play. Sherman now facing off against Anderson. Puck comes in, McLeod all by himself, sticks on the ground, shot, score! Jim McLeod! Cheverus' defense falls apart, McLeod walks in alone once again, and this time, stick works around Neto, and an easy score. The Trojans lead 4-3 with 2:43 left. They'll still have a power play, they'll get one man back, Will Cheverus, but they'll still be one man short. Unbelievable action. Gets his second, and it's 4-3 now. The Trojans chance for a big upset. Bell trying to keep it in, knocked out by Anderson. Acetto picks it up, clears it in for an Academy zone. Sherman gets the assist on the McLeod goal. For an Academy still on the power play, 5-on-4. He scored that one on a 5-on-3 situation. Acetto clearing it. Over there is Hazard. Hogan has to go back for it. Hogan knocked down behind the net. Got to be careful. Gets it off now for Troy Karen. Karen winding up. Stolen away, though, by Anderson. Anderson with the puck along the boards. Now picked up by Acetto. Cheverus, great forechecking. Centering pass, Bell. Good job. And now another chance. Here comes Sherman with a breakout. Getting back, though, is Hoglund. And the shot in on Neto. He makes the save. Whistle a face-off to the right of Dan Neto. Almost a breakout for Sherman. Minute 43 left in the contest. 55 seconds left in the power play for Thorne Academy. If I can keep my voice throughout this one, I'll be happy. I got to rest it up for Tuesday night's game with Thorne Academy's boys basketball facing Bonnie. Breakout for Fasulo! But Marston out of the net beautifully! To knock it away! Michaud trying to keep it outside the zone long enough to get Fasulo to clear. Jeff Marston, a ballsy play to come out of the net and knock that away from the barreling in Fasulo. He was 30 feet out of his crease, and he does the trick. What a contest. Sear knocks it away. Trojans still on the power play for 35 seconds, but Cheverus with their first line out there of Malloy, Fasulo, and Michaud controlling action. Chabot now with the puck. Looking, clears it out now. Picked picked up by Hoglund. And we got a face-off. Just outside the blue line. 1:04 left in the contest. 16 seconds in the power play. As we take a look down at Bob Bolduc and the Cheverus Stags. Trying to give some instructions out to his team. Still a 5-on-4. Timeout now called. What a game.
Timeout, Timeout.
Board Academy called the time. We'll check in once again with Bob Bolduc and the Cheverus Stags. Time for me to get this plug in. I want you all to come down to the Brunswick this coming Saturday night, February 23rd. 350 cover. We got laser karaoke, which is a sing-along. You got the video and the words up on the screen. You get up and sing with a bunch of people or by yourself, whatever you want to do. This is the new wave to hit the state of Maine. It's been out in the country for about 4 or 5 years, but of course, it takes a little time to get up here to the great old state of Maine. And we'll have that Saturday night. Tournament, basketball, we get the basketball shootout, of course, a great hockey game, this domed hockey game. Hockey players, please come down and check it out. Almost as good as this thing. I've had some games, very exciting, very close to this, but quite frankly, nothing can match up to the game we've witnessed tonight. We saw some overtime games last year with Gordon Kennebunk and Gordon Deering, but this has to be the most amazing hockey game I have called in my brief career. Here we go, the final 1:04, face-off, Sulo going against Sherman. Sherman controlled but knocked in and cleared out by the Trojans. Karen with a chance to pick it up along the boards. He does, sends it in behind Netto. Going back, forechecking is McLeod. Netto knocks it to McLeod, tipped out for Karen. Karen coming out front of the net, winding up, turns, shoots, McLeod, score! Jim McLeod! He got the loose puck out front, Netto couldn't contain it. And the Trojans go on top 5-3 with 48 seconds left. Troy Karen, again, brilliant, wheeling out front, holding. The shot in on Netto was saved, but McLeod able to pick it up and put it past him. McLeod, the hat trick. We don't see any hats. Throw the hats out on the net. We check the crowd over on the other side for Thornton Academy. Trojans at 14-12. McLeod from Karen. And Thornton Academy pulling off the upset tonight. Sherman steals it. Sends it in again, and here comes Troy Karen. He's got McLeod on the left. Shot. Save Netto. Shot in again. Hits the post. McLeod with it. Picked up by Malloy. Here comes Malloy for Cheverus. Sends it out. Bell back for Sulo going for it. Again, Marston out of the net to clear it. Jim McLeod along the boards. Here comes Aceto. The goalie out of the net. In comes Malloy. Shot scores. Not over yet. 17 seconds left. Cheverus had pulled the goaltender, Netto, and it's now 5-4. Cheverus never say die. Cheverus now will call their timeout. Now welcome that pause. You're watching Thornton Academy High School Hockey on CTV 30. It was. against Fasulo. Both teams out with their first line. Faceoff controlled by Cheverus. Puck on the ice. Down there for a long time. Malloy coming out with it. Onside. Drop pass back for Cito. Broken up though by McLeod. He shoots it out. And that'll do it. The Trojans win 5-4. Yes. What a game. Thornton Academy winning 5-4. They hold on and they're mugging. They're mugging Jeff Marston down on the ice. And as well they should. Their junior goaltender, amazing. These two teams could very well meet, as we've said numerous times tonight, this Wednesday night for the first round of playoffs. And if this is any indication, what a game that'll be. Two teams now try to gather it in and suck it up and shake hands and regroup and get composure, because it was a hard-fought, great game. Unbelievable hockey contest. Trojans win it 5-4. Crowd still over there cheering. And this is the team I thought we would see all year for Thornton Academy. They finally, on the last game of the year, get it together. And maybe gelling at the perfect time as we head into postseason. Who knows? But no matter, this was one hell of a hockey game. And you saw it all right here on CTV 30. I'm Jay Harper. We're going to take a pause and we'll be back to wrap this one up from the Biddeford Ice Arena right after this on CTV 30. Welcome back to the Biddeford Ice Arena. Jay Harper regaining my composure. An amazing hockey game. Thornton Academy holding on for a 5-4 victory and winning this one and heading into postseason play. And a good chance they'll meet the same team, the Cheverus Stags, Wednesday night at the Portland Ice Arena. Saves for tonight. Dan Netto for Cheverus had 50 saves, ladies and gentlemen. He was as good as Jeff Marston was, who came up with 45. The Trojans came on strong in that third period and outshot the Stags to get to those totals. Jim McLeod, the hat trick. The kid was amazing, as per usual. McLeod, Marston, unbelievable, as was Troy Karen. The whole team, though, every line that went out there and skated for Bob Rally tonight did their job and did the things to come away with a great upset. The first time these two teams met, Thornton Academy lost 11-3 to Cheverus. This time, a 5-4 victory. They went up 5-3 with only 50 seconds left, but Cheverus answered back with 17 left and got it to 5-4 in the last 17 seconds. The puck was kind of around and knocked around, and Thornton Academy was able to run out the time. An amazing hockey game. Can't say enough about this game. It was incredible. So glad to be a part of it here on CTV 30. Again, just a great job. We're going to regain composure again, take a little break, and we're going to come back and talk to Coach Bob Rally and find out what's in store for the Trojans in the playoffs. We're back right after this. Welcome back to the Biddeford Ice Arena. Joining me now is Thornton Academy Coach Bob Rally. Bob, 5-4 victory. I've said enough. Your thoughts on tonight's game?
I'm still trying to collect them. That's the kind of hockey that I've been hoping that we'd see all season long. We've seen it in flashes and in spurts. But tonight, you really put together 45 minutes of some good solid hockey. And it started out, I think, on the first play of the game, we win the faceoff, dump the puck down into their end of the ice. Troy Karen laid a hit on their defenseman and sent it home, and everybody picked everybody up, and everybody just sort of went from there.
It was a great game. In that first 2 minutes, you controlled the puck, had a lot of chances tonight. Troy Karen played a great game. He had so many up close and chances to put one past Netto. He couldn't do it, but that last one, when McLeod gathered it in on his great work as he wheeled out front, I mean, that really spelled it in. Troy Karen's work all night, he stayed hard at it, didn't give up, and kept the pressure on it. Jim McLeod, a hat trick. Marston, 45 saves. Those three kids, amazing. But then again, all your lines tonight were equal to the task.
Every single one of the kids, you know, I think, I don't know, it's kind of been a funny year. We've had a lot of injuries. Tonight was the first time we really had everybody back and everybody playing up to their potential. Not up to their potential, but everybody playing back in sync. And, you know, they really, we got lucky on a couple of occasions, but, you know, with them hitting the couple of posts and missed shots and what have you. But at the same time, we hit a couple of posts down here, and Jimmy, it was nice to see a break come our way with Kyle Valley's shot from the blue line. They're a little risky I think Danny just must have lost someplace. I don't need to make excuses for Danny. He certainly doesn't need any. But I think that a puck that comes up high off of that board there is a little difficult to pick up because you'll lose it for just a second. And I think that might have been what happened.
Certainly did. Netto had 50.
50 saves, as we said. Now, Coach Bob Boulder for Cheverus kind of gave me the rundown on what he thought would transpire in the Hill Point standings if they were to win. But now with the upset, would that put you ahead of Cape at number 5 and move them to number 4, and you might meet again anyway?
Yeah, I think we're destined to meet again on Wednesday anyways. I don't think there's any doubt. If we had lost and they had won, they would have been 3 and we would have been 6. So either way, I think we were destined to meet. I think we're destined to meet. But then again, I'm not a PhD in mathematics, so I don't know. The Hill Point system is, as you're aware, is very, very complicated. It really throws out any objectivity. And you really get into, this is who you played on this particular night, and this is how many points you get for these people.
Could you say, though, with the win tonight and the way you played, I mean, I know it's only one game, but maybe putting everything together right at the perfect time and maybe a big chance for another upset in the first round of the playoffs?
Well, now they've seen what we're going to do. We're going to throw another wrinkle into it, see if we can't kind of change it a little bit and throw them off. So he's going to go back these next couple of days, and I'm going to go back, or Larry and Ron and I are going to go back these next couple of days and try a couple of different things and throw a couple of different looks at him and see if we can't befuddle him. At the same time, he's going to try to do the same thing to us. So it'll be a good rivalry. I think that with all the marbles on the line, that we're going to find out what we're made of.
Now, we had two real exciting games last year that we covered against Deering and Kennebunk. But would you say tonight was the best, or at least the most exciting hockey game you've been a part of in your coaching tenure at Thorne Academy?
It's going to rank up there. This one is a landmark for us. There's basically in Western Maine hockey, there's the Big Four. There's York, Yarmouth, Greeley, and Cheverus. And they pretty much dominated the Little Four, now Little Five, which is going Kennebunk, Cape, Lisbon, and ourselves are in Scarborough. There you go, Scarborough. And this is really our first foray into knocking off one of the Big Four. So, we've come close a couple of times. We've played well against Biddeford. We've played well against Greeley. We know we can skate with just about any team in the state. And we feel that, we definitely belong out there. So, you get that kind of feeling. Who knows what's going to happen? This is a funny game. Funny like that.
Certainly is. I just want to congratulate you and your team on a great season and a great game tonight. Good luck in the playoffs, most likely Wednesday night at the Portland Ice Arena against Cheverus, the team we just saw tonight. It should be another great hockey game, hopefully another upset victory and move on in postseason play. Fans, please come out and support the hockey team, everyone in force Wednesday night at Portland to see Thorne Academy, and we think Cheverus, we're not sure, but regardless, they will be in the playoffs. Check your local papers for time and listings and things in your area. Coach, once again, thanks for a great season, and just good luck in the future.
Jay, thank you, and thanks to CTV 30 for being here and giving us a thrill on Sundays and Wednesdays. Appreciate it.
As big as the Thorne Academy boys' victory was over Portland, Thorne Academy boys' hockey team pulls off a great upset, beating Cheverus 5-4. That's going to do it for us here at the Biddeford Ice Arena. I'm Jay Harper for my cameraman, Mark Cantor, saying so long. We'll see you real soon.